What's up, y'all? It's Chad. So what is a sermon series? Is that something I've thought about a lot? And if you're watching this channel and you're part of church, you probably can answer that question. If you're not part of church, you might be saying, okay, what is he really talking about? But sermon series are a style of preaching that have been in vogue for a while. And a few years ago, I began thinking about them in a kind of a different way. And I just want to talk and make a video today about like my idea of sermon series and how I like strategically try to preach. And really what it kind of boils down to is there's like three different kinds of sermon series, and then there's a fourth way that I preach. And that's how I do it here in North Louisiana. There's four types. The first type of sermon series I'm gonna talk about is what I call a major series or a big series. I typically, when I'm looking at the whole year and thinking about things, I'm probably gonna have three strategic sermon series that I'm going to preach during the year. And I'm gonna preach them a lot of times at critical places of the year to where I know like, this is when people will be coming to church. This is when like the natural rhythms and patterns of stuff are going on now. This is post-COVID, and so every church and their attendance patterns have changed dramatically. But generally what I look at when I think of where's the right time for big sermon series or for major series, I think about after the new year, before Easter. I think about after school gets back, and then it's post-Labor Day. I found out in my context where I live, those first few weeks of school, those last few weeks of August, people are still just kind of getting in the new rhythm of things. And then I think about the summer. Now, I'm going to leave Christmas, I'm going to leave the Christmas season, the Advent, that whole idea, that's completely out of this. Like, that's its own unique animal altogether. And so I think strategically about what are some big series to preach now. I think about that with what I feel like God needs to tell our community, where I feel like God is leading our church. I also look inside of my own giftings and where and like what am I good at preaching at and these sorts of things. And I think critically about this for months, and I kind of go into the year knowing, okay, I think these are gonna be the big series that we have. And then I'm typically gonna like begin purchasing resources for those and prepping those. Like I have a very unique way I preach those types of moments, and I want to be like ultra prepared. So I've been reading for a series that I'll do this fall. That's gonna be a very, very long series for me. It's gonna be 8 or 9 weeks. That's very long for me. I've been prepping and reading for that series for over a year. Right now I'm finishing up a series in the Song of Songs. I've kind of had resources floating around for a couple of years, but I began thinking about it intentionally about a month before the series started, and it was a big series. Now, big series also for me, for our church, we're a church of around 140 adults. We don't have a full-time communication staff, that sort of a thing. But for big series, what I like to do is I like to have that series to be branded really well. So what our slides look like, the images for things look like. We try to make invite cards. Like part of a big series is also, we really make sure people know it's special. But we also think about what's gonna draw people in. Like what is a conversation that's gonna wanna make people change their pattern and way of life to come and be part of that. So those are major series. Like I said, I do those 3 times a year. Now, I also have a habit called mini series. Now, normally when I preach, I try to stay off. When I first got out of seminary and back into the local church full time as a preaching pastor for the first time, I did like a new series, always start on the first weekend of the month. And then the next week and the next month, a new series starts. And y'all, sermon series are not your calendar. I think we can wear people out when we're always like pimping the next new big series. That's why I've kind of started doing major series and mini series types of things. And so mini series are just a couple of 3 weeks, which could be the same amount of time as a big series, but those are series that we are not going to just like throw all the rigmarole behind. Those are gonna be more like, and I can't even say like discipleship or something focused, but those are going to be building in just core identities of who we feel God has called us to be here at our church. Now, we're going to make sure things are done well, but you know, we're probably not going to make promo videos for them, that kind of stuff. We're not going to try to find any companion ideas. anything like that. And those are gonna run a couple of 3 weeks. We might stay in those for 4 or 5 weeks sometimes. I found out actually when I'm preaching like a mini series, a lot of times I will let that run a little bit longer than it has to be. And a lot of, and also what I think about is, okay, how can I build in 2 or 3 of these things to really begin building in like a strong like peer foundation of an idea before we go into like a major series. And so that's what I'm thinking about with like mini series. The next way of preaching that I do, and I don't do this as much, some people do this a lot, I don't do it as much, as just kind of straight books of the Bible preaching. Now, I hear people throw around the word expository a lot, and I've heard so many different definitions of that. I don't really know enough to define it on my own, other than for me to say I'm not generally an expository preacher. And I think that's because of my main theological viewpoint of biblical interpretation that I found very helpful is biblical theology, which is, instead of being focused on like, you know, bringing one single verse, pulling that apart, it's looking at large pieces of scripture. And so that style of like, we're going to stay in the book of Matthew for 3.5 years, that is just so far outside of who I feel I'm called to be as a teacher, but also what I've seen resonate with people. And so this third way of preaching is we'll go through a book sometimes, but we're generally going to go through that book a little thematically, and we're not going to keep like some linear focus. So a lot of times what I'll do in those realms is I'll figure out, okay, I want to do this for 2 or 3 weeks, maybe 4 weeks. Okay, what are four like major, my friend J.R. Forresteros used the term scaffolding. Like, what are 3 or 4 major like landing zones that I feel like people need to have to understand the tone of this book? And so I've got that going on. So occasionally, once a year or so, I will do a through a book series like that. And some of those have been great series. Like, I preached Jonah years ago through the book, and I did it literally. But I also did that as a big series, which I talked about first way. And then the fourth way that I kind of think of sermon series is during the year, and when I'm prepping out, I'm going to think about, okay, what are a couple of books of the Bible that I want to spend a lot of time in devotionally as well as scholastically over this year? And what does it mean for whenever I have a week or two off between series, which I always try to do because I don't want to just rag people out with thinking about, as always, this thing, and then this thing, and then this thing, and this thing. What are a couple of books of the Bible that I'm just gonna make the choice that year? It's like, you know what, I'm just gonna spend some time over the year in this. And so when I have, I'm spending time in there devotionally, which is the first thing I think that has to be happening. And as I'm spending time in that book devotionally, I'm seeing things that I feel like would be beneficial in a teaching scenario. And I will use those books for what I call like one-off Sundays throughout the year. A couple of years ago, it was the book of Isaiah and the book of Psalms. Over time, it's been the Gospel of John is one that I do that a lot with. And Psalms, like I love the Psalms, and I feel like we don't take enough advantage of the Psalms. And so for the last 2 or 3 years, I've preached at least 3 or 4 or 5 Sundays with a Psalms text as my primary preaching text. And so those are the 4 ways I think about sermon series and the way that I found them to be helpful. So I'd love to hear from you in the comments. If you're a preacher, if you're a pastor, I'd love to hear what you think. If you just go to church and you've got questions or you've got things you want to say, I'd love to hang out and interact with you in the comments. So I'm Chad Brooks. If you like content like this, do me a favor, like and subscribe to this video. And then also tell me more of what you would like to see inside the comments. And so I'll check you later. See you next time.